Okay, so today I just want to show you how I make a whoopie sling without a bead or without a binder or a hook. And this just prevents when you're tightening up your long end, it just keeps it from pulling through if you don't have one of these, a binder or something to stop it. So this would be an external binder or bead or whatever you have. I don't have any beads. I don't want this on my whoopie sling. So I'm just going to take a another piece of material. I'm going to wrap it around my finger. That would be about the size that I want. The size they want of my final loop. Big enough to grab my finger. And I'm going to add about an inch or so for a tapering. And I'm going to take my tool. I'm going to start about a half inch on the outer side of the jacket. And I'm going to just start about a half inch from the splice. You can do this anywhere you want. It's not that important. I just do this for aesthetics and for my OCD. So you can start fiddling it through. I go about a half inch and then I check it to make sure that I didn't get anything, that this tool here didn't pick up any strands of this cord here. Okay, now that I'm sure that it hasn't, I'm going to start bringing this through. Okay, this is not a splicing tutorial at all. It's just trying to show you how I make an internal bead for my whoopie sling. Somewhere I have a mark here. There we go. And this should do it here. And there we go. I fit through. Now I've taken, put a pin through the end of it so I don't have this follow through before I'm finished doing what I'm doing. Okay, I'm going to open up my fit a little bit here. And I'm going to pass this through halfway. I pinch it, close it, and push it. And I start by milking it on. And there we have it, it's coming at the end. Take off my fid. And you can see why I put the pin in here. So what I want to do is I want to start my taper just where I want this to be, just in a little bit. I want to try to keep this diameter the same as this diameter, just for aesthetics. So we'll pull this through a little bit. That's good enough. Like that, milk it through. Now the end here, take off my pin. I don't want to taper the other end. That's the part that's going to keep it from going through, following it through. Okay. And there we go. Now, I'm going to stitch this because this internal piece is going to migrate one way or the other and your loop's just going to get bigger and bigger and bigger and it's just not going to be nice. So what I do for, I'm going to set this aside for now. Okay, so for, I don't have any whipping thread. I just use a scrap piece of whatever I have kicking around. This today I'm using the scrap piece of zip-it, the 1.7. And I'm going to take a strand out of this I like doing this because using a strand of this because it's the same color of the product that I'm using. So any stitching essentially becomes somewhat visible. And what you want to do is you want to get a strand, pick any strand, pull it out. And then you can milk the strand out. Just keep milking it out. Until you get the whole strand out. Now this piece is about 20 inches long. I don't waste this here because it's got 8 strands in this piece of rope. And that's 8 pieces of thread. So I'll just keep this piece for later and when I need some more whipping thread for sewing or whatever, I'll just take that out and we'll set that aside. So now I have a piece, one strand of the fiber. Now it's really flimsy, it doesn't hold together well. I'm going to add a little wax to this and all that does is helps me keeping it from this thread from fraying. It's not twisted. It's just hanging in there. So, I'll take my needle first. Now you can use paraffin wax, you can use candle wax. I have a piece of beeswax here that I use for my axe handles, to wax my axe handles for grip. It's what I use. You can use whatever you like. So I'll start off by just, I have a little slot here from previous times I waxed. I'll just put that in there and I'll just scrape it across. So once I got my my strand all waxed up the way I like it, keeps it nice and taut, clean, makes for a nice medium for stitching. I'll start stitching the piece I put in. There's no big deal about the stitching at all. You can probably have done it yourself anyway. So I'll stitch it through, make it taut, and I'll stitch it from one end of the piece I put in all the way to just probably right up to the crotch where the two meet together. And again, when I'm all done, I just want to make sure that this piece slides through like with no problem, right? And when I'm all done, I end up with is my internal, what I call an internal bead. Okay, and it's stitched in, I can't migrate up and down. And I can take my end, I can pull the whoopie cord, and the loop will only come to about as far as I decided I was going to make the loop, big enough to put my finger in. So that's it, no big deal. So you don't need a bead, you don't need a binder for your loop. I'm sure there might be other ways of doing this. This is the way I come up with because I had the stuff at hand. I like using the thread from the product that I'm using or strand. I add a little wax to it, make it easier to keep it from fraying. And it's for aesthetics. It's still just as strong. I don't know if you can see the stitching there. You can, but it's the same color, so doesn't bug me too much. Okay, so that's it for me. Enjoy. Have a great day and happy splicing. Bye.